Ultimately, we are all, Secretariat, the member states alike, accountable to we, the peoples. Together, we can and must do better.
The Internal Audit Division serves the UN in the same way a family doctor would serve a family. We come, we do regular checkups.
We find it, you know, signals of potential problems. And we kind of give them an alarm and tell them, you have to focus your energy on these problems.
They are really, if I can say, a kind of friendly eye. We're watching our steps and watching our back as well.
Auditors are really there in order to help improve how the organization utilizes its resources.
It keeps us on our toes. We do need, not only for control purposes, but also in order to get somebody to give us ideas about how things could be done in a different manner.
As agents of change, we promote a culture of constant improvement for better UN performance.
Every day, nearly 40,000 secretariat staff around the world are working to fulfill the challenging mandate of the United Nations.
The United Nations is an extremely risk-exposed organization. The United Nations is most often present and working under exceptional circumstances, war, conflict, natural catastrophes, breakdown of infrastructure. There is no excuse for having poor internal control mechanisms and for tolerating mismanagement and certainly not corruption and fraud.
Understanding the risks involved in managing the United Nations. In 1994, the General Assembly formed the Office of Internal Oversight Services, or OIOS.
The new Office of Internal Oversight Services will make this organization more efficient, more effective, and more accountable.
OIOS is divided into three divisions. Inspection and evaluation assesses the relevance, efficiency, and effectiveness of the organization's programs. Investigations establish facts related to reports of possible misconduct to guide the Secretary General on jurisdictional or disciplinary action to be taken. And internal audit assesses the adequacy and effectiveness of internal controls to improve the organization's risk management, control, and governance processes.
There are nearly 200 people in the internal audit division coming from all over the world. I think the peoples of the internal audit divisions, we are diverse. I think we are well educated, a lot of specialists in our field.
The Internal Audit Division serves UN clients through four services, with a presence almost everywhere audit clients are located.
We really appreciate the fact that the Internal Audit Division, most of the time, have people present on the ground, and that is the first step to understand what the issues are.
Audit staff work with over 50 clients in the United Nations to understand their objectives, assess risk, conduct audits, and make recommendations.
But it's critical that we have peace in the organization in the United Nations that gives us check and balances to really find whether within the control system we are doing things properly.
Throughout this process, auditors adhere to strict professional guidelines.
Part of being an auditor is to make sure that you are independent in whatever operations you do. Clients may have resistance, but it is very important that we hold our ground if we see that this is what we are supposed to be doing.
As an auditor in the UN, we have to have some kind of a moral, you know, responsibility to the larger public outside.
Wherever the United Nations mandate takes it, there are auditors in international criminal tribunals, special political missions, and peacekeeping missions, like UNMIL in Liberia.
We're very concerned at this point in the mission's life cycle about the environmental damage that we may have done while we're here.
When we came to this place and we did a survey, we found this whole place littered with cars. We thought that it would be a good idea that we comment it in our finding and find out what exactly caused this and what action should be taken by the mission.
I think the environmental audit is a very good example of how we have worked together to solve potential problems in the mission before they become major issues.
The mission has taken immediate action, and this action has paid off. Now you can see literally very few cars here in this place. So we need to uphold these standards, especially the environmental standards, and demonstrate to the local people that we care for their environment.
In keeping with internationally recognized best practices, auditors use a risk management framework. The first step in most audits is risk assessment, taking into consideration internal controls.
Internal controls are those risk mitigating actions that management engages in order to achieve its objectives. The role that that auditor would play is to look at those controls and then make recommendations to management. But all of these things are purely recommendations to management, and management always carries the responsibility of deciding whether to implement or not to implement.
Audit is a must, is something that is required as part of our accountability framework, but it's also something that, if properly done, is a key tool for management. So you need to provide information, you need to be open.
The internal audit department will do the risk assessment with the cooperation of the client. We do not just sit and say these are the risks that the organization faces, because we are not the expert in that field.
I'm very happy that they're doing those audits. Some of them are welcome very much, and we have extensive discussions on the recommendations. Others, I don't like that much. I want constructive criticism. And in general, I think we have a very good relationship, and we have a very frank and open dialogue.
It takes two to tango. So it's not only from our side as management, but it's also from the audit side.
Using the risk assessment, auditors develop a work plan that focuses on high-risk areas, emerging issues, or areas of concern, like the Capital Master Plan.
In terms of this, you say you're on schedule.
We're comfortably within time.
On site at United Nations headquarters in New York, Auditor Gordon Bird works closely with Ken Champion, Director of Construction for the $1 billion Capital Master Plan.
The role I have involves talking to people from the Office of the Capital Master Plan, making sure that the things are going according to plan and that things are done to the right time, quality, and within budget.
It's just that it comes out like a jigsaw puzzle.
Yeah. But this is their thing down here, isn't it?
With internal audit, we approach it as their teammates. We discuss problems and challenges that we were having, how to get through them.
In the past, it may well be that some people thought that auditors were the type of people who would sneak up on them and try and catch them out. I know that all my professional colleagues do try to adopt a constructive point of view and to add value to an organisation.
They're sincerely trying to help the project. They give you some constructive criticism. And there's a very open dialogue.
From July 2008 to June 2009, OIOS issued close to 400 reports with close to 1,900 recommendations. Nearly 90% of the recommendations issued during the past 3 years have been implemented, with financial implications of over $30 million.
If you look at the sheer weight of recommendations that the auditors have made and the rate of implementation of these recommendations, that gives credence to the fact that the auditors are a really important part of the UN system.
The Internal Audit Division is a tool for improvement. So if properly done, clearly helps the organization to grow and to perform better.
I believe if there was no internal audit, would be like a plan without radar, because the role of IOS is to foresee obstacles, prevent duplication, and ensure our integrity and our seriousness about accountability.
It's a partnership that should always be there for us to be able to deliver well today, but even better tomorrow.
В партнерстве с вами на пути к улучшению Организации Объединенных Наций.
Para lograr una mejor Naciones Unidas.
Ensemble pour une meilleure organisation des Nations Unies.
内部审计师与您相伴，携手走向更美好的联合国。
Partnering with you towards a better United Nations.